Okay, third time lucky. Third take. Right, hello guys. Looks like the sleep ebook is live for $9.99. I just went with a nice stock standard cover because the colors look like comfortable. Right, they're like comfortable colors, and I don't know, I thought it goes really well actually with sleep, that brown and yellow. So just a nice stock cover. And remember, if you buy the Organic Portals Handbook, don't get it from Amazon. Or you can, and the advantage is it's in a EPUB format, which means you have basically the contents page as a hyperlink that takes you to sections of the text. So it can be quicker to navigate and manage. That's basically the only advantage, though. Because I do give it to people for $50 in PDF via email, and that's signed and non-publicly sold version, so it's a little bit different too. Anyway, wanted to get into Aaron's email here, which I was talking about the other day. Very interesting questions. This is Aaron, who has donated to the channel quite generously over the last year. Thanks a lot, Aaron. I really appreciate when you helped with Oro that time he had the ear infection. I'll never forget that, you know. Really appreciate it, Aaron. God, thinking about Oro makes me sad, but nowhere near as much now because I just keep realizing how perfect it is that he is where he is there on that mountain. I think he knows it, and that's why he didn't come back when I called him, because he didn't want to leave. He's found his territory, he says, for sure. You know what I mean? Because even when I went back the next day, he didn't come, you know what I mean? So that's why he jumped out my arms and sprinted back, because that instinct would have just kicked onto his nose like a radar. You know what I mean? His scent trails distancing and the female scent trail distancing, and he just had to run back. And he thought, I can't be out here in the urban society with these dogs. Anyway, so these are questions from Aaron, and I did reply some above, and I wanted to talk more on it and definitely put it in a video because they're very interesting. Don't know what I'm going to call this yet, this video, but let's just get into it and I'll figure out a title later. Number one, I understand organic portals can easily be hacked or possessed. Why is it they can come and go whenever, but we cannot? I think almost no one can get out of body. Oh, I didn't even answer that. I misread that the first time, Aaron. Why is it they can come and go whenever, but we cannot? I think almost no one can get out of body. Is it really just need to practice? Are we not strong enough? I understand, but don't understand, if I could put it that way. Yeah. Certain gods, goddesses were also said to embody certain animals. The whole thing with animals, I still haven't published the video, but there's a guy who has a goose in USA and he walks around with his goose in the shop, and I could tell it just suddenly hit me one video. I watched a few of his videos and I realized, oh shit, he's a goose. And I don't mean derogatorily, you know, paying him out, but like legitimately, that is the archetype I saw as a shaman, seeing him. And I was like, oh shit, he's an actual goose. You know, in an upward organization principle manner, now stewarding a goose from, you know, actual goose body, like an actual goose. And so what that would be that that goose in the next life will be one of these base NPC people. What we're calling like animal human organic portals. So it's just part of the upward organization principle. I mentioned that before in a video where I was talking about the cat in some lady's video and relating it to Oro. I think Oro will also be a boy in his next life if he comes here. If he's reincarnated or whatever. However that all works. which we've got to get to the bottom of. I've got to keep looking into it at least as the channel goes on. I understand organic portals can be easily hacked or possessed. I think up here I said my reply. One. Well, I didn't answer that because I was like, yeah, well, that's the obvious. Yeah, obviously organic portals are easily hacked and possessed. Right, that's the whole point of spiritless humans, if you use that nomenclature of spiritless, that moniker, that descriptor, you know. Why is it they can come and go whenever, but we cannot? I don't know how you mean that, because it sounds like you mean their spirit can come and go whenever. But actually, what it looks like is, you know, they have, you know, infiltration of spirits that come and go, and those spirits may just be in this dimensional construct. Do you understand? So, you know, if they're coming from another universe, and then you're like, well, then they're getting out, in and out. That, I understand what you mean by that. So say they're coming from another universe to inhabit an organic portal, like Satan coming down and going into one. You know, that's not how I see it. I see it that we don't understand these dimensions properly. And that, you know, if we understood these dimensions, a lot of, anyway, these entities coming, you know, into people and through people would not be like escaping to some other place in the context of, you know, out system or out of this matrix completely. It would be in the sense of, yeah, they go back to where they come from and, yeah, in and out of the body. Which, yeah, I most definitely can do. And, yeah, it definitely is to do with practice and stuff like that. You have to, you know, even if you say eat differently. Like, if I eat meat for a whole week, I'm not going to be doing much OBEs in the same fashion as if I'm, like, fasting for the week. You know what I mean? Then, you know, you got to think about your emotions and attachments and where your thoughts are. What are your thoughts circulating on or attached to? So yeah, that would fall under the practice, and that we're not strong enough in a way. But yeah, I've had OBEs and, you know, dimensional travel and all this stuff, right? But I don't think it's correct to say, you know, why are they coming and going? But maybe it is. Let's entertain it for a moment. Well, then I'd suspect like a frequency control or something, like some sort of, you know, control or capping of our energy, stopping us from this in and out motion that you were trying to think about, which is really a good question. I really like this question. And one thing I said here to reply was, seems we are glowing. I said seems we, I don't even know what I meant by that. I think I meant like seems, yes, like as in yes, it seems we are not strong enough. No, that's how I kind of like ended. Yeah, that's what I was saying. So seems we are clearly light body weak. Yeah. And, you know, you go out and ground and do Qigong in nature and do some martial arts in nature, grounded, you'll feel a difference very quickly. And yeah, there's something Don Juan said that reminded me of something he said. Our glowing code of awareness is kept at the toe level. At the toe level. Our glowing code of awareness is rendered only to a little sliver left at our toe level. So when you, if you were to be like fully grounded all the time, you'd be much more like Oro the cat, the golden gato, the cat that I've just been, walking around with for the last 3 years. He was always grounded, and he had just such, he's definitely his own spirit. And if we were to walk around like that, I mean, you can see the piercing gaze of the cat, right? You can see it sees other things. I don't know if I published this video yet, but at the shack, he saw an entity. He was staring at something up in the corner. Then guess what happened? The whole fucking door fell off the hinge. The top hinge. How the hell did that happen? It's definitely a physical intrusion by a non-physical, what looked to me anyway, as nothing there. I thought maybe I saw like a little wormhole, like, wobbly space fabric, you might say, like a portal. But that's all I saw. That's all I could even sense at all. And Oro was just staring. And then the door fell off the hinge. Now you say, well, that shack was very old, yeah. To have it happen exactly when he was staring at it is no, happenstance coincidence. It's definitely something was there, because twice he looked at me like, yeah, I'm looking at something, like he was trying to tell me. And he just looked straight back at it. And he was looking in awe, so he didn't really understand what he was looking at, but he could see something, you know what I mean? So yeah, that whole light body weakness would be a big hindrance of coming and going in OBE, out of body experiencing and stuff, right? Yeah, very interesting question, because I don't see it like the organic portal themselves is coming and going. That's how it sounds like you wrote it, but I'm assuming you mean like the spirits that inhabit them and stuff like that. And my answer to that was like, I don't know if they are going. Maybe that's just to our third dimensional perception, and I think they're just going back to their dimension and or their universe, which is beyond the scope of this talk to explain and talk about. Because I want to make a video, the difference on dimensions, universes, and parallel timelines and all of this. I don't want to weave that in right now. So let's just move on to number two. Do you know anything else about how gang stalkers use smartphones? A few YouTube videos mention using them to remotely operate implants or steal DNA light codes, but not much else. It's interesting. I wonder who taught. I'm gonna have to have a look into that. I'd really like, Aaron, if you could send the videos of what YouTube videos talk about the remotely operate implants and the steal DNA light codes. Who has said that? That's good. I like it. And because, like, I would agree with the operating remotely operate implants. Well, could just be done via frequency and bits, how this whole internet is operating in similar fashions. It's just information technology. And the stealing of the DNA light codes. Well, this is interesting because I and others have noticed that gang stalkers and their technology are like very mentally entwined, and like I've had thoughts in the past of aliens coming through the tech. In one of my videos, I think I've caught the sounds in previous videos, some of my earliest conscious zine videos that you can see. Pretty sure I even titled one "Grey Alien Invasion" into my like video or something. I don't know where it is, the Conscious Azim playlist or the Gang Stalking playlist. So I find a lot of you guys don't dig back through my videos, by the way, which is weird. Anyway, because when I find someone like me, I go nuts. If I found me, I'd be like, I do a playlist at a time. I'd go, okay, let's go to the Conscious Azim playlist and go through all of those videos Then I'd go to the gang-stalking playlist. I'd go through all of the videos. Anyway, that's so interesting. Interesting though, to remotely operate implants or steal DNA light codes. Yeah. Do I know anything about it? No, not really. This is very, this is obviously ultra fringe, right? This is super fringe. On the fringe of not just society, but even on the fringe of epistemology in general, and you know what can be done and how things work. But you remember that a cosmic particle can change a computer's computing, right? Like there's a famous example of a voter. They thought it was voter fraud, but it was actually cosmic particle which changed the way that the voting thing voted, the machine or whatever, and it had a ricochet effect of 4,000 votes being incorrect. Pretty interesting. I think that was on Vsauce's channel on YouTube. And so, I mean, all that brings me back to is just how everything is, you know, an information particle, right? Like when you are communicating through the URL of the internet, that much I do know because I learned that very extraneously and physically. And you know, there's packages of code, and then there's, you know, headers of the message, and then something that tells you the message is even coming, right? It's an embedded process just to communicate like this via the internet. And but in the end, yeah, it's just little figures, right? It's just little informational figures. They're little packages of bits and bytes. And I mean, generally it's the same with, you know, our DNA, right? Like, it's good you put DNA light codes. Can they be stolen via a phone? Jeez, the way I would think about it is just the reading of it. And if you can read something, then yeah, you could say that you can take that information. And this, it seems far-fetched, but there's just maybe an oversight, a very simple oversight that we're not thinking about that would make it very tangible. You know what I mean? Like it could just be just that one little bit of knowledge. It's like if you don't know how to root a phone, when you find out how to root a phone, you're like, well, fuck. You know, I can just go around rooting everybody's phone and operating on their phone. You know what I mean? But before you know that rooting how to, it seems like magic or impossible or that can't happen. You know what I mean? That type of thing. Yeah, we're playing around in that same sort of area. So I don't specifically know anything on it. Let's see what else he says. When everyone is doodling on phones, I have to wonder. Supposedly they are just like anyone's, but with added technology. Does this monitoring help the Matrix hack targets? Well, it would if they're doing it, wouldn't it? Because the remote operating of implants. Now that actually could just be fully simply explained by frequency, by just putting a certain hertz, a certain frequency to activate a device. And even if that is in an etheric sense, you know what I mean? What I mean by that is if it's an energetic implant, even you could activate that with another frequency, right? Like we know how schematics, when you increase the tone, it increases the complexity of the pattern. I mean, that could make physical switches, you know, switch and operate and turn things on. I mean, all that stuff's very easy to like imagine happening for sure. Let's see what I did say, but yes, there's not anything that hacking cracking can't accomplish in a phone. But when I say that, I mean that on a very tangible level, you know what I mean? Like very very physical, tangible level, and that's very well known. I'm sure I was. You could do it too. You know, you can hack people's phones and stuff. It just hacking and cracking is even cracking is hacking. It's just hacking away at something. That's all it really means. You're just really inspecting something and figuring out, you know, can you compromise the system and blah blah blah, right? Anyway, I'm sure you could probably get apps to help you these days and everything. I'm sure I was spied on through my camera during certain times, is what I said, definitely. And I'm sure they still do it. And I could hear that in either the people that were my handlers near me, or my, what do you call them, remote neural monitoring handlers. So whichever it was, they would say, oh yeah, we're looking through his camera. And I've seen my screen get screenshots. The whole screen just blinks, and I know it's a screenshot. They used to do that hardcore at that Camping Mirindia place, like when I was watching Bear Grylls a lot, Man vs. Wild. It was very funny when they would do the screenshot. I would always be watching Man vs. Wild, but what they were trying to do was like get screenshots of my pornography. I knew it. I knew that they were doing that from the temporal adjustment of their screenshots. So, for instance, the day before I was looking at porn at 4:55, and then today the screenshot comes on at 5 p.m. You know what I mean? And they would follow me around like that, trying to get dirt on you, basically, right? And I said also, and their network is larger just due to botnet ability. Yeah, you can always botnet, which means, you know, you take over my computer and you join it in your network of hacking. Yeah, I said, just imagine all of the techniques from information technology. So whatever I learned in my degree, it can obviously be done. And they hit me with the gamut of this stuff, electronic harassment. I've undergone like so much stuff. Like they can drain your battery. The Angel virus, do you remember that? When, what's his name? Julian Assange, he published an article about something called the Angel virus. And the Angel virus can actually just suck your battery. Like it uses your battery to do what it's doing on the back end of your phone. It's called the Angel virus. That's from the CIA. Congrats. I have to thank them for that. Yeah, and then I put here, yes, even stuff is going through frequency to aliens, I think. Yeah, so, I mean, I don't know how it all works exactly, but I agree with that sort of, those sort of statements and questions that you're putting forth here. Just don't know every little nuance of how it works, you know. Here, let's see here. He asks, I think it's safe to say our enemy is the financial institutions running our lives, run by organic portals. So that's an interesting point before I even read on. This is that lower view of the matrix, right? Where you think society is the matrix and that's all that the matrix is, but we've really updated that to be this whole universe is the matrix, all of physical reality. So I just want to push way beyond that. And are they our enemy? Well, in many senses, yes, because they are ruling over the energy. And you know, money is energy. It's a current of energy. It's a currency. And you know, it's like raw energy. It's like if you were to take Planck length energy plasma and turn it into a physical object or a molecule or something, right? It's the same thing with money. It's a raw form. And it's yeah, a raw form of energy. You go to work, you put your, you know, physical energy, your kilojoules, your spiritual, mental, and emotional energy into your job, And then you get these little pieces of paper which say this much raw energy to buy physical stuff, right? So yeah, I would say it's they've created themselves as a bit of an enemy as well. Some say most doctors are clones with demons, but the thing is, my point is that, that I didn't say in the background is that we can also change it. I don't know if it has to be our enemy, you know what I mean? That's the hope of the future anyway, if you're still hopeful. Some say most doctors are clones with demons in them. Yeah, most definitely. That's like just such a good way to describe the white coat doctors, and shamans as well. But the average doctor, definitely. I mean, demons are in words, in books, as well. So wherein you read it and it becomes your brainwash, it's like the demon can manifest through that language in your head. And yeah, anyway, besides all that, I'd say, yeah, just definitely straight up to that sentence. Doctors are clones with demons in them, like very, very tangibly felt comment, Aaron. Because this is on the level that I talk about the seven devils of the human ego Ethereum platform. In that sense, that sentence is just pure. Because they are all too often. I'm trying to think about if I've met a doctor, not like that. But some of them, they're quite, soulful and they want to do you good, right? But yeah, there is a shitload of doctors who are clones with demons in them. And that's what I was saying about in the text. That would go with the word clones. It's mental cloning. That's not their original thought, brainwashing and indoctrination. So yeah, a decent way to put it. It is something to avoid hospitals. Yeah, it's one thing to avoid hospitals. Yeah, I'll tell you why. It's like just a wreck. If you're like one of us and you do not want it's just a lowering. They're gonna put like, mess with your physical body, put things in there and stuff up your energies, give you pharmaceuticals that'll just kill your mind, etc. I mean, this is all the obvious stuff. But what about when it's time to go to the morgue? I asked Akvil Sava if she ever remote viewed this. She was not interested or didn't have time for my post. Does it matter what happens to the body if the soul has left? Again, you're talking about the soul as in the spirit, which I've said a million times. The soul is not the spirit. When you guys talk about the soul flying around, you're talking about the spirit flying around. When you see a depiction of a white, spirit flying in, astrally out of someone, that's not their soul. It's a spirit. Anyway, so does it matter what happens to the body if the soul has left? No, it's part of this place. I mean, does it matter to you? I don't know. That's up to you. Do you care whether they use, I don't know, your physical body part in someone else? And then, well, yeah, that's an interesting question. Would that then somehow still connect to your spiritual energy? I say nope. Once you go past the great gate or the gate greater and or fifth dimensional field, all that escapes is the spirit. None of the physical body gets out, so it's a complete detachment, I assume. I think so. Maybe attachments can not be fully severed. But in out system, completely out system thought, and not even dimensionally in some sense, I'd have to say no, it's a complete disconnection, and you don't care what worms eat the body that you leave here. All it's going to do is raise this place alchemically, alter this place in a positive fashion anyway. But so far as, having some sort of detrimental effect on your spirit, which is now gone and out of here, I'd say no. Can be used like a voodoo doll? Yeah, I think no. Because you've left, like as a spirit. I'm hard on saying that. Hey, maybe I change my mind one day because I realize something else, but I really don't see that at all. It's a great, interesting point. Can it be used like a voodoo doll? Well, you have left. What, to me, it doesn't seem the body has a dominion over my spirit once they are parted out of this world, right? And I'm fully dead. So I don't care what they do with the body. That would be your ego saying, oh, use me like this or that. It's irrelevant. It's not even relevant to where you're going, I don't think. Theoretically, someone using black magic could capture your soul bioelectricity. See, the spirit is not bioelectricity. That's what I'm trying to say. This is in-system thinking, what you're presenting me with. And I seem to be some kind of leader of out-system thought. Well, I've titled it that. Actually, out-system thought would be, the reality that, the spirit is not bioelectricity. Well, this is a bottom view. You're saying it's projected from here. I'm saying the exact opposite. Creation happens down dimensionally, and so spirit is projecting this physical body in bioelectricity, not the other way around. And there are one-way flow valves, so dimensionally speaking, down dimensionally, so hence, no. That's why I say no to this whole point as well. Like a genie in a bottle. No, I don't think so. I don't think there is a physical substance that traps the spirit here indefinitely, like you're thinking. I don't think so, because that's the point. Yes, if you see it, what I think is erroneously as bioelectricity, then yeah. But I don't think my spirit is biophotons. That's what I'm saying to you. Do you understand? So it's a nice concept, on this lower level, but I don't think that the spirit itself is bioelectricity and capturable. However, I may be wrong, and it could be, right? Which makes the view of the future very scary, with all the increased tech and thinking like this, that they want to do this type of thing. And then it would be the case of your spirit being like 11th dimensional, right? If we're going to look at it that way. I just don't think that's the case. Right. Anyway, I think what I'm trying to refer to is what Lisa Renee, Ascension Guide, calls bio-spiritual harvesting. Well, that's something different. That's definitely a different thing here. I can see how it's connected, but it's also a different thing. For example, things like organ transplantation, yeah. Blending soul blueprints. So we've got to see the soul then as, a database and information and, yeah, it's interesting when people do organ transplantation and the blending of, if I take on Fred's organ and I have a heart transplant, that's probably a good example because it's, the heart, which has a massive influential field compared to, say, I don't know, your left kidney or something, you know what I mean? It's going to have much more spiritual endowment, your heart as well, rather than say the liver or the kidney or something, or your stomach. And yeah, in that sense, it's interesting that people report having the feelings of the transplantee, or sorry, the transplanter, the person who they got the organ from. They say that they feel their feelings. Well, that's just trapped emotional and ganglion, middle nervous system type of stuff. But that doesn't mean that the soul is there. It's again like Stuart Hameroff from Consciousness Institute's theory about the soul being in the microtubules. I laughed, and I still laugh, and I say that it's a fantastic idea, like a go at it, but I'd say that that's an imprint, which is gives a latent and lagging notion, and that it's not the essence itself, that that's a notion or middle idea, if we're going to refer to Spinoza's three levels of ideas. Remember, we recently just read. So yeah, no, I'd say it's like a emotional stuck energy. That's not their soul. It's just like an imprint and a circulating, just like a ghost, like a lower level ghost. You know, it's like some sort of fourth dimensional imprint. And it's very interesting that that is a different thing, but it's kind of related, kind of relative to what we're talking about. Because it's funny that ghosts repeat, they're repetitive. And the ones that I saw myself in my real life fit that as well, like a repetitive cycle. So that's interesting, right? I mean, you could just be an idiot and say, oh, yeah, it's a simulation. Like, but we're looking for more information. I guess you could include cannibalism or worse, being put into a nano or robot body. Yeah, look, this goes to the great ceiling and something I mentioned in Organic Portals Handbook that you've read, that you might have been taking a bit from that as well. How I said, well, you know, the energy's different. In some sense, you know, maybe they can develop a polymer one day that's basically identical to the human biopolymers that nature's created, our body. And that kind of thing, but I mean, definitely not now. It's not here now, I don't think. Because I've read into cochlear ear plants, you know, cochlear, the world's like, I'm pretty sure, biggest like ear people, you know, the famous cochlear implant, ear devices for hearing, and they were talking about their polymers and the next generation polymers and all this to increase the efficacy of their technology. And I was reading about that something like 8 years ago, and just going off stuff like that. I mean, I know that's not black budget, that's not deep state and all that, but on that level, on just the everyday societal level, there's no way they're near it. And you say, you once heard Left Side say, if you don't die right, your ass is coming back here. Yeah, and other people are saying that too, right? If you don't die right, your ass is coming back here. This is interesting because Oro also sent me a message in that first week he was gone. And there's no way he died straight away. He was still sitting up on his mountain meditating to me, and we were connecting our thoughts, and he would have picked up on me thinking that he, you know, are you all right in dying? And he was saying, well, you're thinking about death. And he was relating to me information about how to die. And it was very similar to a video I saw of some elder of some island tribe just getting dropped off on an island and just left on the island. Presumably, you just crawl up in a ball and wait to go. That's what I thought. What else is he doing around there? Dancing around, maybe a ritual, I don't know. It seemed like this old guy was just ready to go lay down and die. And that's what they did in their culture. And Oro said, yeah, you can't be around people. So if you like die in a hospital, that's probably not good. You know what I mean? Especially with this, the cubed consciousness, right? It just reeks of the exact wrong way to be dying, right, in a hospital, ungrounded, unconnected to everything, not connected, right? surrounded by organic portals, technologies of all sorts, and all this, right? Just so, yeah. I don't know exactly what way is the perfect way to die, but we're definitely going to keep thinking about it. Yeah, no one says much what to do about all this, though. Yeah, like left side, did he say more on it? No. Left side just covers the top end of everything, right? It's not super deep over there, in my opinion. Anyway, I mean, it's difficult stuff, right? We don't get taught this in school. We're the ones that are gonna have to figure this out. I find this ridiculous, and it makes me think back to things I've said, like the baby boomers are like epitome organic portals. And did the Matrix just start yesterday? Like, fuck, it's some trippy stuff to think about. And then you watch all the reset stuff in the 1800s and missing time. And I just, it's very interesting how this could be a simulation of memory implantation. But then, oh, we have the physical dinosaur bones. And yeah, it gets a little confusing. Anyway, years ago I watched a guy. Again, that could be just implanted physical, I understand. Anyway, let's move on. Years ago, I watched a guy on YouTube who seemed far out yet smart, knowing astrology and everything. He said they can trap a soul in the spinal cord with the body disposed of and put you in a drawer or something. And this is interesting. Again, it's the same thing about an imprint. The fluency of actual spirit not being there anymore. That makes me go, okay, that could be done, but it's not how as grandiose as you're imagining. And that's always the befalling of the dark side. They're always like that. They're short-sighted. They're myopic. It's the ones of the light who have the far sight, right? Dark ones have a short sight or myopia. And yeah, they're still using the same force, you know, the Sith are using the same force as the Jedi, so to speak. But they're very myopic. Anyway, and so this is just another sense of that in their technology, because they always, you know, when we approach these things, it's like a Doppler effect, a technological Doppler effect, right? You approach this thing and it's fast, it's like, you know, you don't know. It's consciously too fast when you're approaching like these new technologies. But then when you get there, you think like how it becomes lame, outdated, and legacy very quickly. And, you know, not as all assuming, all capturing as you originally thought approaching it, you know? This just, it reminds me of that. Like, yeah, okay, they'll do that one day for sure. They'll try and trap soul, whatever that means. In the spinal cord, right? And dispose of their body and put them in a drawer or something, just collect people's spinal cords. But that's not going to be the soul, that's not going to be, it's going to be imprints, and it's definitely nothing to do with your spirit trapped in there. It's what people need to get a grip of. Spirit is getting out. It's because it's non-tangible. This is tangible versus non-tangible. The soul still has the imprint of tangibility, but it also has, you know, for instance, the template. A soul template is in some sense tangible because the sixth dimension works like that onto the third dimension. It has to arrange via its sixth dimensional nature. So yeah, a soul imprint in a spinal cord in a drawer, yeah. Then what are they going to do with that? Lots of cloning and, you know, extract maybe information that could be construed into strings of information like code in a computer system, or extract someone's thoughts before they died. Yeah, that's all gonna happen for sure. But make sure you realize what I said about spirit not being able to be trapped in there. Anyway, what's it say here? You said, you would be totally conscious yet immobile. Yeah, no, I disagree with that. I'm not going to be existing ever in a spinal cord, conscious of, you know, in some sort of like paralysis. To that that sort of thinking around it, no, in my opinion. You'd be totally conscious yet immobile. I mean, this is a dark lord dream. It's a wet dream of theirs, I'm sure. I think the spinal fluid is what allows your brain to be conscious in 3D. That's interesting you said that, because Rise of Five from, I think I even said this in my reply. Ryza said, from Game of Enlightenment and Abundance, he was saying how, yeah, this part here, oh, that's what I already said, okay. Spine fluid indeed will need its own field of science. And when I heard him first say that, I was like, yeah, okay, I understand, like, how complex. And I said here, light body multidimensional can't be trapped by lower electrical light, is what I meant there. I put loser electrical light. I think that was a typo, genuinely. But they will surely invent that and try. The bottling of your geniness is done while alive. Yeah. Hence, raised vibration, the movement. Just trying to stay awake in this place is very difficult. You're within a bottling. You are the genie in the bottle here. It's happening now. They don't need to put you on a spinal cord. Yeah, bodies degrade, like I said, so no voodoo dolling in the sense that we were talking about it here. Yeah, about dying, right? I even had lessons. I was talking about that. Yeah, it's telesentient fluidics. So, how this all works. I mean, again, you could sort of think of it on just a hyperlight drive sense, like the mushrooms communicate in our mind when we take a magic mushroom. Relate that to, how we have visions when we push more spinal fluid up through the pineal, right? We start the spinning of the crystals and so on. Yeah, but like I said, it's telesentient fluidics, though. Is not the spirit. Just imprint here, like I always repeat about Stuart Hameroff's theory about microtubules and the soul. But here, yeah, I mean, I'm always open-minded on this, but there's a hyperlight drive connection. And we don't know fucking dick all about this. Maybe some deep state people know something. But I'm always reminded of Terence McKenna's little What's So Great About the Mushroom 5-minute spiel, where he takes on the mushroom mind and speaks for it. And he says, the mushroom says through him, we'll trade our hyperlight drive knowledge for a position around a star less forsaken. So clearly, mushrooms are picking up that the star, to this planet is not in a good way. And they can be picking that up millions of years in advance. We don't know how long, right? Science says a certain amount. But hey, apparently the atomic clock changed the other day, so they don't really, know a perfect timeline, science, do they? Because, time is, even the Planck constant or whatever is changing, and it's just, sorry, the speed of light is always changing. Through time, the speed of light has changed. So it's not a constant. Anyway, but this would require some serious know-how and tech. And you would need remote viewing, probably too. Yeah, you'd need people like us. They would need to usurp people like us. Like, it would have to be like a Stranger Things type of thing, where they take kids, teach the kids all the, telekinesis and this and that and blah, blah, blah. Right, it would have to be like that and done like that. I don't know. I suppose maybe you could, you do have the ability to do it with technology, because technology is just a simulacrum of whatever we want to call the base universe, electrical universe, or whatever you want to call it. Some people call it a luminous or bioluminescent universe or something. Anyway, but. My point is, with technology, you have the ability of translation, like bits to bytes and so on. I mean, you have the ability to, sorry, change formatting. Sorry, that's what I meant. So you have, you know, a vector graphic, you know, PNGs and stuff can go to JPEGs to, you know, different formatting. You can go from from vector-based graphic to bitmap to understand, or analog and digital, same sort of thing. So the translation ability in technology is always there. So maybe you don't need someone like us to do that. The end answer there, the end of my answer where I'm talking about, you know, you would need to visually, you would have to have that connection up through the dimensions. I mean, a technology can't do that. So you would need, this is a very interesting idea, because you would need somehow a base beingness and the tech to read it afterwards. But you would need a base beingness, you know what I mean? Like, my point is that I don't think that the spirit would be trapped in the spine, and then, you know, they're just using your spirit to piggyback or steal the information from. They may create like a beingness, like a real beingness. Like, it's very hard to talk about this. It wouldn't just be like a far infrared being. Like here I said, like, infrared beings are still phenomenous, in my opinion. You would need numinous nature and beingness. So for instance, you know how we can pick up galaxies in infrared, and you can't see them in physical light spectrum. You would need the whole spectrum in order to have the complete communication. So do you see how complex that gets? Like, it's really not as easy as putting a freaking spine in a jar and saying, hey, I've captured this person's essence. All you've captured is their imprint. Be soul imprints. That's it. And then all they can do with that is use that information for their benefit. But they don't have you. You understand? And in the sense of you just being bioelectricity, no. That's still tangible or phenomenous. Well, I'm talking that the spirit is noumenous, not phenomenous. Anyway, all right, let's keep going here. Yeah, he said, this is deep, like he didn't know it all either. Yeah, because like I just explained, it is very deep, and you kind of have to understand how everything works to do something like that. That's really playing God, really, really playing God, you know. Climate change is not playing God, because God can just, or you know, the universal flow could just overflow that, the state of, you know, the harp technology or something. Anyway, I also watched a blonde girl recently who said your soul must be charged for what? Oh, for example, if you die in hospital surrounded by steel, yeah, and cubed walls, cubed consciousness. For instance, when I came to Uruguay, I slept 2 weeks in a 10th story or something. It was like 8 stories up in my university in a medical room. Basically, it was just a really insulated room up in the medical students segment. I was not supposed to be there, but I somehow managed to lock myself in and sleep there for the 2 weeks I could save, the final money to get here. And what was interesting about that was I felt the difference in the morning. I felt like I wasn't like escaping at some level. Like my consciousness at some level was being boxed into that room, and it was very heavily like insulated sort of room. I don't know what was in the walls and et cetera, but all I knew was that I felt the effects of that square room with no windows and everything. Do you understand? And it's, what I was saying before about, if you were to die in the hospital as well, that would be one factor. And there's many more factors, like not being grounded and not being connected. So where is your spirit gonna go, because or does it even have to transverse any of the phenomenal universe? See, I suspect no, and so it wouldn't even matter if you die in hospital. That's my big suspicion. It might not even matter at all, because there's this complete new nomos ability. And so numinosity is not contained by phenomenicity, but phenomenicity does act like a container, but it's not, it doesn't stop the numinous. That's the kind of part of the meaning of the word numinous, has like a slip between the gaps of physicality meaning, not just micro scale. Okay. Yeah, so this blonde girl who said your soul must be charged, again, you're mistaking soul and spirit. And I've already given you the Organic Portal Handbook, so what are you doing? Like I said, soul is like database, so spirit is the energetic, right? Even left side of the brain said that like 2 years ago. But that's just the basics that we all know, so you're doing that wrong still. And this is a good example of when you have mismatched schemata like this, you can't think properly. And how I always say that organic portals can't think properly, it's because they're using incorrect schemata. So the mindscape is completely confused, which, could be hindering escape, by the way, as well. Anyway, for example, if you die in a hospital surrounded by steel walls, it will drain the plasma out of you. Is it possible that the steel stops the plasma? Geez, what level are we talking about? You know what I mean? Are you again replacing a word? Or are we talking about plasma on a very Planck length level? And is that even phenomenal? I mean, to our physical body senses, that's not. All right? You do not feel the Planck length in the sense of how you feel air. So you swim in water, it has a larger viscosity, and you swim in air. You're walking around breathing the air, but really we're immersed in it, right? Like it's an ocean of air, the atmosphere. And in that sense, yeah, you don't feel the Planck length. You know what I mean? It's completely, basically non-physical to our senses. You know what I mean? To especially the, extended nervous system or brain. Maybe it is registering it at some deep subconscious level, but I think you understand what I mean. It doesn't appear to be. It's definitely not on your consciousness. Yeah, so I don't know what you mean by plasma there. And steel walls draining plasma out of you. Maybe you didn't think while you're writing so much, because that just doesn't even sound, sensible. Stopping the steel wall, stopping plasma, and then I get that we're still talking in the same sense as the previous paragraphs. And then what do I say to that? Well, I don't know. Again, it's you're seeing it as like, I don't know, thick bioplasma or something, and saying that that's, spirit, bioelectricity and thick plasma, and I'm again saying no. Anyway, and you may not be able to survive death. Yeah, like have a proper crossover. Well, in the sleep ebook that I just wrote, I talked about how sleep is crossing over. I mean, this all seems to me the dark side of your mind rearing its head? Fantastic questions, but remember the family of dark sets up the structure for the family of light to find their way home to the family of love. Anyway, seems hard to find videos on this type of subject. Yeah, look, they're definitely at deep state level going to be experimenting with all of this and bioplasma. But so far as, you know, bioplasma being the human soul, that's just so a stupid view. That's their view. That means you're not taking into account the chakras above your head. Have you seen the diagrams of the chakras outside of your body? You know, there's more than the seven main chakras inside your body, so to speak. There's lots more to think about than is as simple as some of these people that you watch on YouTube. When your cat was on the mountain, I remember you said he was showing us how to cross over. Yeah, I was talking about that earlier. Was I implying we must literally run away into the woods where no one can find us? And that's what I was implying earlier, yeah. And it would be a focus thing, right? How are you going to look forward when you're looking back, kind of thing? Or if you're looking at Greg to your left, you're not looking within, type of thing. It seems they have it set up just right, so you cannot even be responsible for your own family, assuming they even have souls. Eventually, we will be forced to watch family members die, yeah. I've been thinking about that a lot too, you know, what am I going to do when my parents die? I'll only have you guys, and it's been a bit of a shit fight to survive on your guys' money, you know what I mean? And, you know, emotional support and everything else, right? But I feel like we're growing closer, a lot of us here on the channel, so it's going in the right direction anyway. I had a horrible start, right? There was a lot of organic portals in the organic portal movement at the start. Where have they all gone? Pretty interesting, no, I was correct. And the views have dropped like 90%, so that number's there again. Anyway, the old 90% rears its head again. Is there another secret to dying no one knows? Yeah, well, fuck, I don't know. If no one knows it, do I know it? This is definitely where my channel here is going to go, right? And my work in general, because I think everything tantamounts to me wanting to get the fuck out of here, really. Is there another secret to dying no one knows? I also heard you must exit the body at a 90 degree angle. Supposedly more mental and emotional than physical. Why does that make sense, and where did you hear that? So what, spirit would come out of a laying down flat body at 90 degree angle? Well, that's generally how it's depicted, right? Through movies and cartoons and so on, isn't it? But I don't know anything about that. But it is depicted like that, so this may go into like half of these questions here, basically all of them. I'd expect you to be able to talk about this sort of stuff with Masonic people on a lower level, but they're never going to say all the stuff that I just said. It's always from the lower level and very physical, which is just nonsense, right? It's like taking in half of what exists and thinking they're going to rule everything with half. That's how I describe organic portals and their nonsense. And the family of dark in total. I think in some cases there is nothing wrong with killing yourself, even though it is bad karma. So yeah, the whole thing of suicide is very interesting because people are saying don't do it. But I think that was an initial view. I also have a video I never published from like 3 years ago where I was saying that. It's like a no-go, I was thinking, but I was just supposing. I wasn't concluding. I was at the time, and I mean, that's the correct view to take initially, for sure, because I mean, you better get it right. yeah, In some cases, there's nothing wrong with killing yourself. Well, recently I've been thinking that. You know, the monk that burned himself alive and he just sat there and he lit himself on fire for some cause. It was like he was trying to raise awareness of something, I forget. I can't remember if it was, I think it was like a Tibetan monk, right? And he burned, it's the cover of Rage Against the Machine on YouTube. If you type in Rage Against the Machine, that band, the whoever's uploaded that video has that monk as the thumbnail. It's a very famous image. There's a monk and he burned himself alive and he just sat there, obviously in a very nice meditation where he would not have been able to feel the pain. Because you can do that, right? We see that that is their practice, putting the chi over the nerves. And that's a state of non-parasitosis. That's very godly. Cleanliness is next to godliness, and that is an amazing example. So in the sense of, you know, dying, well, what a way to go. He burned his body, so he made sure, firstly, he did everything himself. He didn't leave it to chance, so to speak, or organic portals to decide what to do with his body. He made sure he burned his body, right? It's a very important point. No, so it that voids and nulls the rest of this conversation, right? If you were to burn your body, then no one could do nothing with it. No, they're not going to reconstruct it from ashes. Good luck. And that's another point, you know. Everything that burns comes down to carbon, but there's still some carbon left. Anyway. And there's no, you can't do that to the spirit, is what I'm saying. You know what I mean? So again, to reiterate over this, the monk that burned himself, well, he took charge, so he did it himself, right? He made a spiritual decision. He made his own decision. You know. So he took it into his own, he took his life into his own hands, and I feel that that is, you know, if there is, you know, a good God, so to speak, that is what he would empower, not disempower. If it's ego, then it's obviously it's a different story. But yeah, so he made his own spiritual decision to burn himself. He made sure the body was, you know, taken care of, so no one could meddle with that. No meddling. And here's my point and what I've been thinking of, for quite some time now, that if you create your light body sufficiently, then it doesn't matter what happens to the physical body. And it's completely not you. It's like people are still very much caught up that they're this, you know, this machine body, which is just such a baby ridiculous idea to even be holding on to, that has absolutely, you know, no basis. There's no core centrism, because basically the body is one large body. Our bodies here, I mean, are all clones, right? In the most literal sense as well. And bad karma? I don't know. But what I've been thinking is that if you have sufficiently created light body, you can cross the rainbow bridge. And I also talked about this and mentioned this in reply to you, Aaron, in the bottom of the OP handbook. You remember? So yeah, that's what I've been thinking recently, because everybody's like telling me, no, you can't kill yourself, that just gets you reincarnated. I think that advice is 100% accurate for souls. These soul humans, but not for us higher spirit humans with the higher light body. Is not it's not for us. For these soul humans, yes, but not for us spirit humans, so to speak, or us spirits, because spirit is getting out. It's the only thing that does get out. Soul can be seen like a database, so wherein you're at the soul level, all you are then is some pretty cool information, but that's reincarnatable. You know what I mean? And in a higher sense, you know, it makes sense to like not see that as bad karma. I don't know why you would be saying that that would be bad karma. I mean, I'm not deluded to think that free will exists. I'm not an idiot. Definitely, free will is a complete delusion. It means that you're incapable of seeing the larger patterns of your circumstance. And you are in a circumstance. So yeah, with the killing and the suicide, I think it's different even for different people. For an organic portal, I mean, what do you say to them about it? Well, they're not crossing the Rainbow Bridge and none of that's happening. You know what I mean? So for them, it's just the worms are eating their body. And for them, yeah, maybe it could just be bad karma accrual. You know, disobeying their evil god or whatever, or entities that they're working for or whatever, you know. And you could go into, you know, we could go sideways like that. But yeah. It's very interesting what you said. Nothing wrong with killing yourself in some cases. And it's interesting that you said it like that because that's exactly how I'm seeing it for myself right now. Like, if you have sufficient light body, you're going to be able to cross the Rainbow Bridge. If not, then, you know, then obviously reincarnation or recycling in some degree. For the samurai, it was the only honorable thing to do if they were defeated in battle. Yeah, so that's an interesting point. Samurais and their. It's a type of martyrdom, really, isn't it? That's, I think, what martyrdom means as well. Not just blowing up people with bombs. So, yeah, for the samurai to kill themselves, like, in battle, especially if they were defeated, is like saying. You know, I'm my own spirit, right? You see that? It's like they're saying I'm gonna control myself, everything, my body, all of this. So it's definitely it was a spiritual move for the samurai to do that. No point killing anyone else either. May as well go for yeah. Well, to kill other people, that would definitely add to like anything. Called karma, right? If there's anything like that. So it may as well go for it if your work is done. You know, that's the thing of the completion of the light body being the most important thing. And that's why I laugh at so many people not buying the Organic Portals Handbook, because they can't even put $50 towards, you know, their possible escape. And so on, and salvation, and so on, right? I think that's pathetic, absolutely pathetic. So most of you on my channel I actually view as absolutely pathetic in your spiritual work, because, you know, for instance, I started Conscious Zen and I did it for years without any payment from anyone, and that was just completely spiritual push. You know what I mean? I was just completely doing great work the whole time. And that's thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars because I could have been working some job and getting paid. You see what I mean? So when people are like, oh, I'm not going to buy the Organic Portals Handbook because it's $50, all I can do is laugh. It really is and it's not like some smug laugh. It's like, oh my God. Like at first it's like that's it's like a laugh of stupidity, but then pity, you know what I mean? Anyway, but perhaps we should decide when or how we go instead of artificial spirit or lower electrical light, as you put it. Yeah, you definitely, you know, I don't think that the AI it seems to get us close into these deadly situations, but then miracle always occurs. I've said before, we have the power of miracle. They don't, organic portals don't have that. You see that, right? It's like you're watched so closely by a higher god or something. That's what it feels like. And I, in my life, I've had this just so many times. so many times because I'm so crazy. Right? Like when I was a kid, I was the craziest kid out of everyone, by the way. So you knew all other kids with ADHD, but I was the number one crazy. It's just down to less frequency control. I'm freer mentally. Anyway, would be nice if there was a giant laser gun that could vaporize your whole body at once. Well, they've got those. I'm sure we could arrange that, but they just. Oh, and this is a very important point. Why don't they let us, go out? It comes back to this being an energy extraction matrix and wanting to keep you here, doesn't it? Because sure, they could make a big vaporizer for all people who wanted to get out. If that was what we all decided, we're like, yeah, we just want to press a button. I don't want to be here. For sure, we can make that. And then we've got, euthanasia and stuff already. But how come, they don't just let anybody do it? You have to commit some crazy crime where you're too hard to handle by handlers, go to a jail, right? Get super handled. And then, they'll put you on euthanasia as a type of power over you. So, in a dark sense, not in a, oh yeah, here, I'll help you escape. It's not in a good sense, is it? Which just speaks fathoms and volumes on what this place is and what's really going on. They don't want you to escape. I don't know how common all this crap is, but okay. Anyway, awesome. Yeah, I even said that here. Awesome questions, Aaron.